This is Indianapolis coach Retro Wayne, and you're listening to the For the Culture podcast.
With the 240th overall pick in the seventh round of the 2019 draft, the Indianapolis Colts select Jackson Barton, offensive tackle, Utah. This is a 6'7", 310-pound offensive tackle. So right off the bat, he has the prototypical size to play the position. And that's what we do with both of our last two picks of the 2019 draft. We add depth to an offensive line that's returning all five starters from 2018.
Yeah, I really like these last two picks. I was worried we weren't going to go O-line at all, and of course I was wrong, and I'm so glad that we did, because I think both of these guys, especially Patterson, have a chance to really make the team and help. But this kid, Barton, is good too. He took over for Garrett Bowles at Utah, did a solid job taking over for him. He's got the size and skill set to be a really solid player. He's got long arms with a huge wingspan that allows him to keep pass rushers at bay. Has a rare combination of size and strength. He played basketball in high school, and you can tell that by his lean frame and athleticism. He's very athletic, and he moves well for a big guy. He's able to get to the second level due to that agility. He does a great job baiting defenders and then sealing off run lanes. He's got a very high football IQ, which is something that obviously the Colts place a high value on and something that I think will help him at the next level. And he can play special teams. He played special teams in college. So a lot of these guys, man, they're super versatile. They can play special teams. They can do a lot of different things. Even the offensive linemen played special teams. So those are just a few things about this guy. There's a lot of things to like about him when you're talking about a seventh-round pick. I mean, he started for 2 years. He took over for Bowles, like I said, and he's got the measurables to really make an impact, make the team, and be a solid backup. Now, the rest of it's up to him. It's, you know, you've got to get in there, compete, and beat these guys out. But I do think he's got the measurables and the base that you need to come in and compete for a backup spot. Some of the issues that I saw with him, he needs to play more angry. He doesn't finish plays strong. That's something that I think can be coached. Definitely with this offensive line, he's going to have to play angry because that's how they play. That's their style. So he's got to learn how to finish plays and play whistle to whistle and not just, you know, let up after you feel like you finish the block. You really got to finish blocks, and he's got to work on that. He needs to work on his footwork and staying low out of his stance. That will give him a better chance to use his great length. That's something that he has. He has really good length, but he's got to be able to really get low and drive into these players, get his hands on them. That will help him neutralize pass rushers. His technique and bend need some work, but again, this is a seventh round. You're not getting refined prospects here. So, hell, we got Howard Mudd back, and we've got Strasser, who's a really highly respected offensive line coach. I think he'll be able to work with this guy and really coach him up on his technique and teach him to finish plays. But not a lot of drawbacks to a kid you're getting this late in the draft. I really like this pick.
Yeah, and as far as finishing blocks and playing with a mean streak, I think finishing blocks comes with the competition. If you're competing not only for playing time to get on the field, but if you're competing for a roster spot, you're going to want to finish blocks. And then the mean streak, that should be contagious. When you watch a guy like Quentin Nelson and the way he plays, the way he pancakes guys, finishes blocks, gets 10, 15, 20, 30 yards downfield, that should make you as an incoming rookie want to play the same way. And he is as highly decorated as they come as a rookie. Pro Bowler, first team All-Pro, drafted 6th overall. Watching him play with the hunger, the swagger, the mean streak that he plays with should become contagious, because we saw it last year. We saw Anthony Costanzo play different. We saw Ryan Kelly play different. We saw all these guys play different because of Quentin Nelson, what he brought to the table for the offensive line. So now if you're an incoming offensive lineman and you watch Quentin Nelson, the way he works, the way he plays, the way he leads, it should make you want to adopt those same qualities, especially if you're a seventh round draft pick competing for a roster spot.
Yeah, and when you were talking about Quentin Nelson and the mean streak, one other person I want to give a little bit of some love to, because we didn't talk about him often, and obviously he's not on this year's team and he retired, but Matt Slauson, I think, was the main guy that brought that mentality in last year, and I think Quentin Nelson followed his lead and everybody else followed his lead in that offensive line room. So I think Quentin Nelson's going to pick up for where Matt Slauson left off last year. I think a lot of people don't really know how much value Matt Slauson brought just with his presence and his mindset, because it completely changed, and we needed a veteran really to kind of lead our young guys. And I thought Matt Slauson really did a hell of a job last year. Unfortunately, he got hurt with that injury, but we definitely got our money's worth out of him. And now with all these young players, the mindset has been ingrained in them. They're going to be nasty. They're going to finish blocks. And I think this guy and also Patterson, when he comes in, they're just going to fall in line. That's how you're going to play.
Yeah, Slauson's definitely the unsung hero of last year's offensive line. A lot of people forget that because when they played their best football, he wasn't on the field, but he was still in the meetings. He was still in the film room. He was still with the guys leading them vocally as a veteran presence. Unfortunately, he wasn't on the field, but the five guys on the field played at the highest level we've seen an offensive line play at in 10-plus years in Indianapolis. And you do a great job bringing up Slauson. I feel like no other Colts media outlets talk about Slauson the way you do, Jason. You always make sure to bring him up, and then I just piggyback on that. But you're always the one to bring him up into the conversation when we talk about the Colts offensive line because he played a huge role in that last year. And then you see a guy like Quinn Nelson because, yes, you have to give credit to Slauson, but Quinn Nelson also just has character traits and leadership qualities that he's just probably born with, just stuff you cannot learn in 1 year from a veteran like Slauson. And that's not taking anything away from Slauson. That's just a credit to Quinn Nelson, because Jim Irsay came out, I'm sure everybody's already heard, it's been like a week, but Quinn Nelson asked Jim Irsay for every single rookie's cell phone number so he could call them, welcome them to the Colts, and tell them what it means to wear the horseshoe. That's not a second-year player. That's not a guy who hasn't stepped on the field yet for his second season. To have that type of leadership installed in you already, I'm so happy with where this franchise is and the character of guys. And we could go back to the Bob Kravitz interview when I had Kravitz on this podcast. We went through Antonio Brown and a whole bunch of stuff, and he said that a bunch of choir boys, which I thought was a ridiculous statement, a bunch of choir boys aren't going to win you the AFC South. You'll finish dead last. Well, it's not about being a choir boy. It's just about being a high character individual. And you have all world talent. You have elite blue chip talent in Darius Leonard, who's pulling over on the side of the road, changing strangers' tires, and Quinton Nelson, blue chip world class talent and ability in a guy who's going out of his way to welcome every incoming rookie to the team. Those are just natural born leaderships. That's high character. That's just good teammates, good leaders, and guys who I cannot wait to continue to build around for the next 10 to 15 years in Indianapolis.
Yeah, I mean, just another thing about Quinton Nelson that I love, and you mentioned this last year on multiple occasions, is how he would run down the field and pick his teammates up after a play or pull them out of a pile. I mean, that's a little thing, but that's the type of player he is, and that's the type of team we are. We are a, you know, one-for-all team. And the thing I love about Quinton Nelson is he just wants to win, and he'll do anything to win. And I think having these younger players that we picked up at the end of the draft come in, and having a guy like Quinton Nelson and Ryan Kelly too, he's got a similar mindset as Quinton Nelson, having these type of guys to look up to, and having the great offensive line coaches and really great coaches that we have, is only going to enhance their chances of making this team, whereas in the past, these guys probably have very little chance of making the team.